Lord Jesus.
I tried to steal the oldest one. I wanted to take her home with me. But her grandma down there, not up here, but down there, was like crazy. And back in my town. Oh, God is awesome.
Yeah.
And I bless him this morning. It's so good to
Hallelujah.
See
everyone.
To die.
My God, my God.
Hallelujah!
Absolutely yes. Refuses to die. I don't care what the devil do. Come on. I don't care what he say. Uh-huh. I don't care. This woman right here, she refuses. She's like, I ain't dying. Y'all crazy.
Amen.
She go to the hospital, they do all of this stuff, they put on all these lists, she all of
she
refuses to die. Because no matter what the devil tried to do to you or what he tried to send you through, you always come back.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Family be like, what? Everybody crying like, oh, Jesus. And she's like, I ain't going nowhere.
That's
what's
right.
Wrong with
you? That's right.
She refuses.
That's right.
She refuses to let the devil do what he wants to do
Amen.
To her.
Amen.
Her.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So glad to see Pastor Tanya here. She went, she not did a service and got and still come.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Thank God for her. And thank you still back there. Amen. For celebrating that and all of you. Pastor Christine, so glad to have you this morning. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Pastor Greer, for starting up this morning. I appreciate it. Y'all are going to have to start doing that because y'all have to understand that the devil fights the pastor.
That's right.
And sometimes I have to just kick behind and flip and do all kinds of stuff before I even get here.
Uh-huh.
So I need a team that's here that's going to, everything need to be going when I get here. So if you're going to meet with me just for a few minutes afterwards, the Lord gave me a little bit of instructions to give to you. But today, praise God. For some of us, we're going to do a little review. And for others, we really haven't talked about the glory.
All right.
Amen.
All right. The glory. If you want to get out your Bibles, we're going to go to Habakkuk 2 and 14. Mm-hmm. Amen. We're going to, there's some Bibles around here somewhere. See if we can get a Bible for them back there. They're in the back of the seats. They want Bibles. I thank God for them children.
Man,
I said simple
amen.
Praise.
Glory.
Simple praise.
Simple praise. Amen.
Simple praise. That's what they just giving God the glory
amen.
And the praise. Hallelujah. One day they'll find it. Habakkuk. That's somebody get help them back there. Some, get them, I need a preacher over there with them to find Habakkuk 2 verse 14. It's a short verse, but I want you to hear it. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to talk about the glory. The glory, last Sunday, the glory fell in here. Folks got delivered. It just fell. And understand that the glory will fall wherever you want it to fall. Because as saints of God, we are receptacles of the glory. We carry the glory. That's what we're supposed to at Walmart, Stop and Shop, wherever we are. If we are doing what we're supposed to be doing, the glory goes with us. So it reads, for the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. So in other words, we need to know about the glory of the Lord. And there was a time that we were talking about the glory, and then some things happened, and Dr. Ron came, and we got away from the glory because there were some things that we needed to learn before we finished with the glory. Amen?
Amen.
So if you just bow your head with me for a moment. Father, I thank you today, and I give you praise, and I give you glory.
Yes, Father.
Hallelujah. Thank you for those that you have sent into the house, because you want them to be affected by your glory. So this morning, we just give you praise. Your word is already anointed. It's already blessed. I just ask that you will anoint me as I proclaim your word, God, as I dispatch your glory. God, I thank you today because you're an awesome God. Hallelujah. Thank you for the children in the house. Hallelujah. Thank you for how you're blessing them, God. They don't really understand what's going on right now, but I know that there's a need. There's some things that you're going to do in that house that they right now, they don't really know about it, but I hear you, God, and I thank you today.
Thank you, Lord.
God, I give you praise this morning. Have your way in this house.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So I said that for some of us, this is going to be a little bit of a review, because 2 years ago, when we started the School of the Prophet, y'all remember, some of you were here then, but the second class of the School of the Prophets, a prophetic word was read that God had given to Rodney Howard Brown, who was a pastor, a preacher. You might see him on television, but God had given him a word back in 2004. And so in that class, I had Dr. Braun to read that word. Now, this word came decades ago. It was in my dissertation that I did to get my doctorate, that this was in there. So when I started the School of the Prophets, God had me to pull up that prophetic word from Rodney Howard Brown. And when Dr. Ron read the word in the class, just before we were to have a break, the glory fell in the place. We never got the break. The glory came and it saturated everybody in the, everybody was on the floor.
Amen.
But me.
Amen.
Now I was saturated, but God wanted me to see what he was doing.
Right.
So I didn't get to lay down.
It's all right.
Everybody else was on, including Dr. Ron, y'all. The whole place was on the floor. And I never did nothing. All he did was read, and the glory just fell.
Amen.
In the place.
Amen.
Now, in that reading, and I'm not going to read all that to you, but what God told us is he didn't need for us to lay hands on anybody.
Uh-huh.
He said, I want to do it.
Amen.
So nobody prayed for anybody that night. God knocked us all out. Everybody ended up on the floor.
Uh-huh.
That following Sunday, I preached about the glory, and the glory fell in the church. Now, this is 2 years ago. The next Sunday, when I preached, the glory just fell in the house.
Amen.
And one of the men that I didn't even know was sick in the Holy Ghost, Vincent, Brother Vincent, got the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Speaking in tongues.
Amen.
Shocked him, his wife, and everybody in the house.
Yeah.
Nobody touched him.
Man.
Oh my God.
My God.
The glory last Sunday just dropped into place. And one reason is that God was trying to remind me and to get me where I needed to be for today. Because today the glory is going to fall in this place.
Man.
I'm not going to put my hands on nobody. God is going to do it.
Amen.
So part of Rodney Howard Brown's writing said, this is what God told him. For I'm longing to display my glory in the midst of my people. This is what God is telling the prophet that he wants him to know. He says, God says, I'm longing to display my goodness in the midst of my people. I'm longing to display all that I am, for they have limited me so much and have put me in a box and have thought that I would only do this and do that, and sometimes even in a limited way. You ever done that? Have you ever put God in a box?
Lord have mercy.
Have you ever thought that he's only going to move one way or another way? But what he's saying today is that he wants to do what he wants to do. We want to run around and we want to be all deep and stuff, but God is saying it's about me.
Amen. Amen.
But in these last days, God said, I'm raising up an army of men and women that will not only allow my glory to be displayed in them, but will allow my glory to be displayed through them.
Amen.
Now, God back then commissioned me, and that commission is still on me, that I need to let the people know about the glory.
Amen.
So, 2 years ago when I was going around preaching, that's what I preached about, the glory.
Yeah.
Because that's what God had on me. And understand that not every church knows about the glory. And not every pastor is allowing the glory to fall in the house the way God wants it to fall. We want a program and we want everything to come into order, but that's not how God moves, y'all gotta understand. Well, God told her to pray for the children. I almost stand up and say, no, you can't pray for the children right now, because that's not in the program. Y'all got to hear me today.
Come on, God.
God wants to do what he wants to do. He wants us to stop running around doing what we want to do. And so his glory will fall in Walmart.
Jesus, come on, come on.
Come on, somebody.
Come on.
If you're a carrier of the glory, if you've got the glory in your pocket, if you've got it in your heart, you will do it in Walmart.
Amen, that's
in the grocery line.
That's right.
Sometimes those cashiers, you look at them, and they got this look on their face like, if you say one word to me, I am through. So God, I've been through these people, these folks, I am tired today. Just come on, let me do your grocery. But when you walk up with your glorified self, when you walk up to them, hallelujah, Jesus,
amen.
And you begin to just, how you doing today? Mm-hmm. It's going to be all right.
Amen.
God's got this too.
Yeah.
And you just softly begin to let that glory come out of you.
Amen.
And go on them. And you see them melting. You see them changing.
Jesus.
You see their facial expression changing. God wants to use us. He wants his glory. He wants us to be carriers of his glory.
Yes, yes.
So, Habakkuk 2 and 14, for these are the days that Habakkuk 2 and 14 was talking about, where the glory of the Lord shall be made manifest, and the knowledge of this glory shall cover the earth as the waters cover the sea. In other words, the glory is going to be everywhere. These are the days that it will share. We don't have to wait anymore. The glory is here. All we got to do is just put on it. Y'all got to understand about this glory. Now, we went through a lot 2 years ago when I was teaching on the glory, and the glory was falling, and we were doing all kind of flips and stuff, and it was hot in here. But then God said, okay, I need to take a break right here because there's some things I need to teach them. And that's when Dr. Ron came, and he did the 9-month sabbatical for me, where I was able to heal and get myself together, and he taught us some powerful things.
Amen.
But now it's time for the glory to continue to fall in this place. And when I say in this place, I'm talking about right here, not necessarily in this church, but in each and every one of you that call yourself Habosheth, saints of God, those of you that call yourself saved. Now, if you're not saved today, you better run to the altar. Hey, that won't shake you. These are the times that you want to see miracles. You want to see, oh my God, you want to see some stuff happening that you never thought you would see.
Yes.
Sometimes we watch a television and we see how in foreign lands, how people are growing legs and eye sockets and all kind of stuff is happening there. But it's here.
Amen.
That's right. Amen.
So what is this glory you're talking about? Revelations 15 and 8 says, and the temple was filled with smoke from the glory of God. In other words, the sanctuary was filled with his glory.
Amen.
So the glory is everything that God is.
Amen. Amen.
It includes creative power,
come on,
radiance, splendor, might, the power to create, to multiply. Glory is the core of the brilliance of God's presence.
Jesus.
God's presence. God's presence.
Man.
God's presence.
Man.
Not perfect, but God's presence.
Man.
Glory releases the supernatural realm in our midst where healings take place.
Amen.
Deliverance, miracles,
yes,
signs and wonders,
yes,
break out.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh my God.
Man.
These are the days, y'all.
Jesus.
These are the times.
Jesus.
You don't always know who you're sitting next to on your bench.
Amen.
You don't always know what God is about to do through
Man.
Them. You don't always know. Hallelujah. So when you come into the house, you need to come expecting something to happen.
Amen.
So if there's a creative power in the glory, when the glory falls, that's when you need to start talking about, I need this. That's when you need to put your money sometime in the offering. That's when you begin to speak. Because see, it's quick. Quick work in the glory. You might have been praying for something for years and years. And the glory falls in the house. And all of a sudden you say, Lord, I need. And bam, there it is. Because the glory.
That's right. Preach, doctor. Go ahead. Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah, God. Come on, Holy Ghost.
Suddenly.
Yes, Lord.
Have
your way.
When the glory falls, that's when creating miracles happen. You ain't got but a little bit of money.
Come on. Come on.
And you go to church and the glory. You don't have to have any church, y'all. You begin to speak into that glory cloud. And there's creativity. Glory is the atmosphere of heaven, just like the air is the atmosphere of the earth. So what we want to do, we want to bring the glory from heaven right down here on earth. God created everything by speaking into the glory. Everything that exists.
Amen.
It has
multiplicity. That's right. That's right.
Right.
Amen.
Hallelujah. That means this stuff multiplies.
Come on.
That might be your anointing. It might be your money.
Yeah.
It might be your children getting saved.
Yeah.
It might be living a life that you know is not pleasing to God. But you begin to speak into the glory. You don't start jumping on them, telling them you can't do this. You're going to hell if you die. You gotta pray into the glory.
Yeah.
You begin to see things changing. After one time about taking people to court, he taught us how to do that.
Uh-huh.
You see, that's all a part of the glory.
Yeah.
Oh my God. I'm talking about the glory of God.
Yeah.
It's him. It's his, everything that he is. Everything that he has ever been. The glory. That's what the glory is, y'all. And when we begin to call the glory down from heaven, right here on earth, that's when you begin to see things happen. Oh my God.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, yeah, my son. That's when you begin to see a 6 or 7 children come out of that house. sing. That little boy, he can sing too.
Yes.
I'm not gonna make him laugh, but he can sing just like all the rest of them.
Lord
have mercy, they thank won't be the same after today.
Amen. Amen.
We need the glory down here.
Yes.
Matthew 6 and 9 says, in this manner, therefore, pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Your kingdom come. We should call everything in heaven to come to earth, and that includes the glory. On earth as it is in heaven, the glory will descend from heavenly realm when heaven is open. So we have to open up heaven. Fed the 5,000.
That's right.
He opened up, he held it up. I'm not gonna go through that whole story, but y'all know the story, how he held up that what he had.
That's right.
And he called down the glory. And in that glory it multiplied and fed 5,000 people. 5,000 men. So that man, it was probably 10,000 women. But you know how men they did leftovers. He looked up to heaven, he praised God, and gave thanks. And that's Psalm 100. He was entering the gates with thanksgiving, and the courts with praise. The glory inhabits our praise. So praise into their lives. I'm speaking an anointing in every one of their lives. I don't care what they're doing now, and I don't care what they're living now, but God's got a plan for each one of those children.
Yes, Lord.
Yes,
yes, he does.
Simple praise.
Yes.
In other words, they're not getting all crazy, and you know how we do. Deep and zingy and all that. I'm talking about simple praise. Just hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
God, I give you glory. Yes. The oldest one, she was, do y'all know she was feeling it? It was shaking. Hallelujah, Jesus. She wasn't just singing. She felt the anointing on the inside of her.
Yes.
That's how Thomas, it came out the way it did.
Yes.
Simple praise.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, my God.
Glory. Yes.
I'm talking about, and when you talk about the glory, and when you teach on the glory, guess what? The glory shows up.
Amen.
Oh, my God. He opened the gates to cause glory to descend.
Yes,
when he held up that food, blessed the bread to their use.
Thank you.
The heaven opened up, and he spoke the blessing over the bread.
Thank you,
spoke the blessing over the bread into the cloud, and multiplication took place.
Lunch. Oh, Jesus.
He held it up.
Spoke
into the glory cloud. If you don't have but a little bit of money, sometimes you need to hold it up and speak into the glory cloud and let it fall wherever you are and let that money multiply. Because it happens in the glory. And guess what? It happens quickly. This is a quick work.
Yes, God.
Yeah.
You don't have to wait no long time if you do it in the glory.
Amen. Amen.
Jesus uses thanksgiving and praise to open the heavens and access the glory. Thanksgiving and praise. He speaks into the glory and multiplication or creativity takes place.
Thank you, Lord.
He shows the disciples how to do this. Cultivate an open heaven in your house and speak into the glory when you need to. You don't have to be in church to cultivate the glory. You can do that at home, and I'm going to tell you what you have to do. I'm going to give you a little bit of instructions. Number one, you have to be knowledgeable about the glory.
That's right.
Like Habakkuk 2:14 says, but the time is coming when the earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea.
Amen.
So when you begin to understand and become knowledgeable what it is, what is the glory, what does it do, how to access it, you become a carrier of the glory. And the more you teach others, learn, and they become carriers.
Amen.
So, but 2 years ago, we were all carriers. We became carriers of the glory.
Yes.
We got the glory. We were learning. We were teaching in Bible study. And so we became containers, glory carriers.
Amen.
Even the babies.
Amen.
Over here.
Amen.
They was carrying the glory.
Amen.
Everywhere they in school, wherever they were. So we become carriers of the glory.
Yes.
How many want to carry the glory?
Yes.
Hallelujah. If you say, if Christ is first in your life, yeah, you will shake him. Start looking for the glory to appear in your life.
Yes.
God's glory can do anything. It's all that he is, y'all. Everything that God is in his glory. And so when the glory falls into place, when we begin to call it down from heaven, stuff begins to happen.
All right. Amen.
When you begin to understand it and become knowledgeable, you got to learn about the glory. Get you some books on the glory.
Amen.
You want to know what to read, ask me later. I'll give you some names because you don't want no crazy stuff.
That's right.
When I first got saved, I read everything. I don't know. I was like the little Pac-Man that was eating up everything that they used to have back then. Somebody had to tell me you can't read everything.
That's right.
That's
some
right.
of that stuff don't even make sense.
That's right.
They had to teach me and back me up.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Amen.
So number one, we want to become knowledgeable. You want to be a carrier of the glory? Know what the glory is. Become knowledgeable of the glory.
Amen.
And then you got to spend time in worship.
All right.
Yes.
Amen.
The first thing you must do is wash in the blood of Jesus.
Yes.
Yes.
John the Baptist said, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near.
Yes.
The blood will remove the hindrances that cause the heaven not to open.
Yes.
You'll never get the gate open otherwise. So in other words, you got to repent, you got to worship, you got to clean yourself up.
Right.
Sometimes you just got to sit down and say, okay, wait a minute.
Amen.
I ain't heard from God in a while.
Amen.
Wait a minute. He ain't done nothing for me lately. Wait a minute. What's going on? What's going on? You got to get in touch.
Come on.
Worship is not praise.
Come on.
Worship is a way of life, a way of living. You worship every day. You worship in your lifestyle. You worship wherever you are. You worship and stop and shop. Because it's in you, it's your lifestyle.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we want to come in church on Sunday and we want to do the praise and worship thing. Well, if you haven't been worshiping all week long,
come on, somebody,
you might get a little praise going on. When I sat over there in that chair and I was holding, I was like, okay, something is missing in here. What is going on? Somebody have not been doing what they need to do this week.
Come on.
Because I ain't feeling what I'm supposed to be feeling.
Uh-huh.
Y'all hear me today?
Come on.
It's your lifestyle.
Amen.
It's what you do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
Uh-huh.
It's not just on Sunday, y'all. Now you can come and you can praise. Lift up holy hands. Maybe they're holy, but you know.
Amen.
Lift up some hands. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Praise
Amen.
The Lord.
Amen.
I praise you, God. I love you, God. I lift myself up to you. I'm giving you praise. That's praise.
Uh-huh.
But what about the worship part?
Amen.
And sometimes, if you have not done the worship part, your praise don't work.
Work. Amen. Amen. That's right. That's right.
You want to have to make nobody get you with you? How come nobody clapping their hands?
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
That's all right. That's all right.
Throwing stuff at me. Hallelujah, Jesus. So, the second, spend time in worship.
That's right. Amen.
That's every day.
Every day.
Every day.
Amen.
Worship.
Amen.
Spend focused time with God, number three.
Amen.
Focus time with God. Get yourself a time that you steal away with Him. That there's no interruptions.
Thank you, Lord.
That you can't answer the phone.
Jesus.
Oh, come on, somebody.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Spend some focused time with Him. Honor Him. Staying focused on Him.
Yes.
It's not self-awareness. The glory comes in your mind.
Amen.
You can't keep focused. Sometimes you have to release some junk.
That's right.
Because you can't keep focused.
Yes.
I know, because it happens to me. I'm like, okay, God, I'm trying to pray. And I'm not focused. What's going on? Well, I know what I do. Everybody don't do what I do.
That's right.
But when I can't get focused, yeah, I go, hey, there goes Shunder on the Ice. Yeah, there goes Shunder on the Ice. Yeah, there goes Shunder on the Ice. I got my Shire. We gotta, when we get clogged up, and all of us get clogged up, our hoses get clogged up, and the water won't flow through, and the glory won't flow through. You can praise.
That's right.
You can worship. Sometimes we have to do a little fasting and praying.
Right. Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Sometimes we have to repent.
That's right. That's right. Amen.
Sometimes we have to just say, God, I'm sorry. I know that was wrong, and I'm sorry.
That's right. Amen.
And guess what? We serve a God that when we repent and we say we're sorry, He throws it away.
Amen.
Brothers and your sisters,
uh-huh.
But if God don't have a problem with you, what? Who cares what they think?
Amen.
Sometimes I just have to say, well, I throw up my hands and say, yeah, whatever. Because I can't please everybody. But if I know I'm doing what God needs for me to do,
Amen.
Then I'm all right.
That's it. That's right.
God gave me, now, y'all, I wasn't always a lover of people.
Amen.
He had to work on me.
Come on. Amen.
Because I was not a lover of people.
Uh-huh.
I could take them or leave them.
Amen.
I mean, I had a real problem. He had to do some stuff when he saved me. Y'all, he had a piece of work on his hands.
Bless you. Bless you.
And it took some years.
Man.
And now I love you.
Man.
Amen.
Oh my God. That's right. Oh, I couldn't have said that because I would have been lying. But today I can say I love you.
Amen.
With a perfect love in my heart. I don't want to hurt nobody.
Yes, Lord.
And sometimes I think He might have overdone it a little bit. Because when I need to fuss, when I need to tell you you're doing wrong, that becomes difficult for me.
Uh-huh.
But there was a time I just said, look, you messing up. You need to do right. You need to get yourself together because this is not working.
Uh-huh.
But now I can't be so harsh.
Come on. Amen. Amen. That's right. That's love. That's love.
We serve a mighty God,
Amen.
God. He will clean you up
from
stuff. Year and the coming days and months, I want you to begin to look, because this is going to be a year of outrageous love being poured out into and through the people of God.
Amen.
Understand that I said into and through the people of God. That means you got a work to do.
Amen.
That means that you got a job to do.
Amen.
Come on, that means that you're going to have to love some folks that you don't like.
Yeah.
I don't know the difference between love and life. There's some folks that you might not like, but that's all right, you got to love them anyway.
Amen. Amen.
You don't hear me.
That's right.
There's some folks that you like, Oh, God, help me to love. And guess what? He'll do just that. Because he is love. And if he lives on the inside of you, you got to love people. Regardless. This is the year. This is going to be manifestation in an amazing release of glory breaking out all around us everywhere we go.
Jesus.
Now this was 2 years ago. It's here.
Amen.
It's here.
Amen.
We are being activated as releases of glory in this season in a new way.
Yes.
Everybody that's saved in this house, activators of the glory.
Yes.
You will be activating the glory.
Yes.
And like I say, if you ain't saved and you know you got sin in your life, you need to get it together because this is not the time. I'm so glad I'm saved right now. God, whatever you're doing in this season,
Come on.
Please don't do it without me. Whatever you're doing in this season, I want to be a part of it.
Yes.
Don't do it without me.
Man.
Oh my God.
Thank you, Lord.
He's doing this right here. He's saying, don't do it without me. That's what God is saying. God, don't do it without me. I don't care what you're doing
Come
in this season,
Amen.
I want to be a part of it.
Yes.
It might be hard, but I still want to be a part of it. So whatever you're doing, God, wherever you're going, I want to be a part of that in this season.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing in this season, oh God, I just want to be a part of it. The glory is going to be falling all around us,
Amen.
Are you ready?
God.
It's time for a love revolution to be sparked and for change to come to our world. Are you ready?
Jesus.
The result of this fresh outpouring is revival. We
Amen.
Had revival last Sunday. The glory of revival fell in here last Sunday.
Amen.
You, Pastor.
Amen.
She was like, go get your stuff.
That's right.
Get your stuff.
Amen.
That includes new doors opening.
Amen.
Some doors are going to be open.
That's right.
Yes.
New doors. Doors that you've never walked through before.
That's right.
Fresh paths being uncovered.
Yeah.
I didn't see that before.
Amen.
Wow, where did that come from? How did I get here? How was I able to walk through here? I'm talking about new stuff, y'all.
Yes.
Now, in this season, revelation exploding. Even as you go off in your foreign missions, I hear God say there's going to be some new stuff happening over
That's
there
right.
that you not haven't even anticipated
yes,
yet.
God.
But when you get there, you're going to shake your ass up. When you get there, you're going to be like, whoa. Yes, somebody, you're going to be fire like you're
going
to
be
fire. My God.
A new fire.
Yes.
Oh, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
New callings.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
New callings.
Thank you, Lord.
And mantles. New mantles.
Woo. Jesus.
New mantles.
Glory. Thank you, Lord. Glory.
Being released to us and so much more.
Amen.
New callings. Evangelist Phyllis.
Jesus.
New callings, baby.
All right. Amen.
Even on your family.
Man,
God is doing something different.
Amen.
To His glory.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Oh my God.
Man.
His glory. See, we was calling in His glory.
Uh-huh.
And it was coming into the house. And we're gonna call in His glory today.
Yeah.
I need everybody in the house to stand on their feet.
Come on.
Come
on.
Stand on. I'm about to shake hands. And I want you to get a feel of this glory.
Yes, Lord.
Glory, 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 God is going to anoint your voice. You're not going to be the same. Amen. After today.
That's right.
Because the glory was here, I saw it.
Yes, hallelujah.
Glory on you is like a bucket.
He pulled down strongholds.
For your glory, yes, Lord, for your glory.
Speaking over our loved ones. I don't care what it looks like. You speak Abba Father's blessings over your loved ones. Come on, let's give him glory. Give him glory. Give him glory. Put those blessed hands together and bless the Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Did not the Lord move in this place? Hallelujah. Come on, let's give him praise. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. The children came and sang an anointed song. I'm trying to tell you the truth. God just blessed through them. Dr. Mattie came and brought the anointed word, and God just moved through the word. The glory fell up in this place. I don't know if you didn't get your blessing, but I got mine. Amen. Everybody God blessed in this place today, let me see your hand. Let me see your hand that God moved. All right, all right. Amen. 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 God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Amen. You want to.
Jesus. Glory!
Oh, God!
Hallelujah! We shall walk your God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Y'all enjoy the presence of the Lord this morning?
Oh, yes.
Come on, let's give him praise. And let's give him praise. Thank you, Lord. He is awesome. He is awesome. Y'all mind if I just be obedient to the Lord? All right, amen. Don and I have been sitting here standing here watching you in that wheelchair for the longest. And can I pray for you?
Amen.
Can I pray for you?
Amen.
Yes, ma'am. Can I pray for you?
She can't hear me.
Oh, she can't hear me? Okay. That's okay. That's okay. You
got to come up to
me. Would you assist me, please?
Oh.
Come here, baby. Come here, Lord. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Yes, God. Brother Jimmy. Yes, God. 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 Father, in the name of Jesus. Y'all just lay hands. Just lay hands on. That's all right. Just lay hands on. Just lay hands on. That's all right. Touch your hands. Touch your hands. All right. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, your name's servant, God. Father, you know all about it, God. The enemy's been trying to give a hard time, but right now, in the name of Jesus, God, we call the enemy's activity to cease over her life right now. God, we speak restoration. We speak divine health. We speak, God, the blessings of the Lord over her life. We call the blood of Jesus, God, that she will never be the same, God. That, God, you're going to work in her life, God, and move every hindrance, every obstacle in the name of Jesus. God, we speak health, God. We speak life, God. We speak the spirit of the living God on this vessel of yours, God. Father, that she will be made whole in the name of Jesus. God, we give you praise and glory. Thank you, Lord. Glory to your name, God. Glory to your name, God. It is so. It is so. Yes, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. In the name of Jesus. God, it is so. Yes, Lord. Your will be done. Thank you, Lord. We give you praise and glory for it right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God. 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 Thank you, Lord. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes, God.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. It is done. It is so. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Bless your heart. Bless your heart. Bless your heart. In Jesus' name. Thank you, God. All right, now. Y'all watch God. Watch God. I'm trying to tell you. Woo, God. Watch God. Yes.
Yes, daughter. You're going to raise up. You're going to raise up out of this chair.
Yes.
Your brain is going to be healed.
Jesus.
Everything is going to be in perfect.
Woo, God.
Yes. Thank you, God. Jesus. Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Jesus. Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
That's right. You are the miracle that God.
Yes. 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 Amen. Amen. Come on, let's give him praise in the house. Did y'all hear me? The atmosphere, whoo, come. Hotter than kiss the evil that I can say, Jesus. The atmosphere is set for a miracle in this house. Thank you, Lord. Woo, glory, hallelujah. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I don't know why God calls me to pick certain people, but what he do, I don't even question it no more. I just call them and let them do what God say do, amen? Amen. Sometimes it ain't all about you. Sometimes you need a little bit of help. Let me put it that way, okay? See, I don't know all the words. You got some, you got some, you got some, you got some. And when it all comes together, see, God know how to work this thing out. Amen? And all we got to do is be open. Lord, here we go. All we got to do is be obedient, amen? Come on now. All we got to do is do what God say do. I think I heard somebody preach on 1 Accord not too long ago. I ain't gonna call nobody's name, but I know when we come on 1 Accord, I know what happens, amen? All right, y'all better stand up, let's get on out of here. Come on, amen, amen, amen. Come on, stand to your feet. Lord have mercy. This thing is good on in here today. I don't care what.
Oh, woman of God a hand of praise for her. I'm just looking at God's people. I'm looking at the anointing on God's people. I'm looking at the glory on God's people. I'm looking at the joy. I see you back there trying. I see you back there. Yeah, I see you, baby. I'm looking at the joy. She just spoke and just let it all come out. Amen. Just let God just use her. I'm trying to tell you. Yeah, that's right. That's right. Just let God use her. Amen. 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 Thank y'all for your obedient children. Thank you for the song. That song was anointed. Those songs were blessed. Go ahead, teach it. You ain't got nowhere to go. Come on back here. Amen. Amen. Matter of fact, y'all come on back anyhow. We love you. Amen. Come on back. Come on back. Dr. Mattie, if you can't get it, we gonna pray in at least for the house anyway, okay? All right. Come on. We pray in. Lord have mercy. Thank y'all so much. Thank you so much. Dale, God bless you. You got blessed. Everybody else got blessed. Amen. Lord, hold your hand. Hold your hands up, Deacon. Hold your hands up, Deacon. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Come and see God will give you some rest and peace. He'll give you some rest and peace. He'll give you some rest and peace. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. How your husband, darling? How your husband? He doing good? Okay, I got a word for him. Tell him I need to see him, okay? I got a word for him from God. This ain't no shucking job. I got a word for him now. I'm trying to tell you. He coming back. Trust me. He coming back. You know. Okay. Amen. 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 All right. Sis, glad to see you. God bless you. I'm trying to pray a woman right there. Pray a woman. God, look at God. Look at God. I'm trying to tell you the truth. Doc, how you doing, man? Y'all excuse me. I just see what I see. Can I just, I'm going to take a minute. We're going to go. Let me have your hand, man. Let me have your hand. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. I'm trying to tell you. God bless you, sir. God bless you. All right. All right. All right. Sometimes that's all it takes. Don't take a whole lot. Okay. All right. Now, our hearts and minds are clear. We're going to stand and be dismissed. And we're just going to say all together, say, thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.
Thank God.